Welcome to Sly Gittin's Tech Simplified channel. In this video, I will be covering an overview of Microsoft Intune, creating an iOS device compliant policy, creating an Azure AD conditional access policy that enrolls users into Intune, and lastly, I'll be showcasing the user experience once an admin has created these policies and implemented them. So make sure to watch the video to the end and hit the subscribe button if you haven't and click the bell to stay notified. Let's go. The Microsoft Intune solution covers a lot, and I'm not even covering 1% of the features that it does. So where can you go to get more information? Take a look at the Microsoft Intune documentation site. You can get setup information, deployment information, best practices. The training that I'm delivering today, I got it from the document site. So go here if you want some more information, and the link will be in the description to help you with your deployment. Microsoft Intune is a cloud-based service that specializes in mobile device management and mobile application management. It can be found inside of the EMS, or better known as Enterprise Mobility Plus Security Suite, that allows for productivity as well as security of your apps and devices. Intune also integrates with Microsoft 365 and Azure Active Directory, giving you the control of who has access and what they have access. So now you know what Microsoft Intune is, let's get into creating device compliant policies. So the first thing you gotta do is go to Microsoft Endpoint Management Admin Center. You wanna click on devices. Let's go to iOS. And then now let's click on compliant policies. Usually we'll create a policy, but in this case, to save some time, I already created a policy. So let's take a look at the properties that I use in this policy. So the first thing we'll have to do, it will ask you, what's the name of this policy in a description? Make sure to pick the platform, iOS and iPad. And then the next thing we're gonna proceed to is compliant settings. For this one, you want to require email to be set up on the device. We also want to block jailbroken devices. And then for the security features you want to enable, let's require that we block simple passwords. And also, we need a password to access the device. And then you can also add, when do you want your password to expire? In this case, I picked 41. And how many passwords do they need to create before they can reuse a password? In our case, it's 5. But in your organization, you could do how many you want. In this case, all we're gonna do is mark it non-compliant. You could email the user, you could retire a device. You can also create tags so you can use for organization. In my case, I just use default tags in this case. And then also the most important area, who do you want to adhere to this compliant policy? I always recommend, and Microsoft recommends, to deploy this to a small subset of users before you deploy it to all of your users. Now that we're done this, now we gotta create a conditional access policy. Now we'll require that all device platforms must enroll into Intune. Additionally, we also will require them to use and leverage the Microsoft Office app, our preferred email client. You can get to this settings in either way to create conditional policies. If you're inside of the endpoint manager like we are, we can do it here. Or if you go to Azure Active Directory, you can do it there. So either way, you can do it. If you're unsure on how to create a conditional access policy, watch my video above, or go to Microsoft Docs and read through the conditional access policy guidelines. So to keep the time a little bit shorter, I created a test policy for Office 365. So the first thing you're gonna have to do is name policy that you create. Select what specific users that you're gonna leverage. If you're doing all users and external guests, I recommend including one user to exclude just in case anything happens that you don't want to happen. You still have an admin account that can go out and change what just took place, right? In this case, I'm just going to be using my MDM users. Next, since we're focused only on Exchange, we selected that application and we clicked Office 365 Exchange Online. And once you do that, now we got to create a couple of conditions. Is for this case, I wanted to focus only on mobile devices, so Androids and iOS. So I just wanted to focus on that. And additionally, I want to make sure that they are using our application that we decided. So we want to use mobile apps and desktop clients, and we want to use modern authentication clients only. So we don't want to use things such as the iOS or Android default mail policies. We want to use that Office Outlook application. And next is we want to grant access, but before we grant access, we want them to require a device to be markets compliant, and we want to require approved client app, right? So you can just see that we want to make sure that they're using the apps that we're specifying and not working around that. And then the next thing we're going to have to do is just turn it on, which in this case we did already. And now it's time to show you what actually takes place when I try to log into my iPad and use the iOS Exchange application and not the Microsoft specified application. Let's go see that right now. So let's take a look at what happens when I try to circumvent and just try to log into my email through the native iOS email client. So I went to settings, I went to passwords and accounts. I'm going to click on Microsoft Exchange. I'm going to paste in my email address, double check for any type of spaces because that can make it error out. And I'm gonna click sign in. Not now, it's gonna send me approve or deny. And it says, hey, help us keep your device secure. Your sign-in was successful, but your admin requires your device to be managed by SG Enterprises to access this resource, right? So it's gonna tell me to enroll now. I'm gonna click that button, and it's gonna make me go through the prompts to get that app and to deploy it. So as you can see, that our two policies works. The user couldn't log in through the native application. They have to go and set up Intune on their device and then go through those settings to get access to your email. So as you can see, it worked. It stopped me from going through the native Apple mail client and directed me towards to download the Intune company portal app. And then I would follow the prompts and then it would give me access to Exchange leveraging the Outlook application on this device, and the device would have been managed. So thanks for watching this video with me. Make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, if you found it informative. Take a look at some of the other videos in my channel. And we got some good stuff coming next in the series, so you want to make sure to click that bell to stay notified.